As I became convinced that it was necessary to use all weapons in the struggle against slavery, including political action and voting, I became increasingly interested in the political movement being organized against the slave power. In 1848, it was my privilege to attend and in some measure to participate in the famous Free Soil Convention held in Buffalo, New York. It was a vast and variegated assemblage composed of persons from all sections of the North and may be said to have formed a new departure in the history of forces organized to resist the growing and aggressive demands of slavery and the slave power. Until this Buffalo Convention, anti-slavery agencies had been mainly directed to the work of changing public sentiment by exposing through the press and on the platform the nature of the slave system. Anti-slavery thus far had only been sheet lightning. The Buffalo Convention sought to make it a thunderbolt. This Buffalo Convention of Free Soilers did not come out against the system of slavery as it existed in the South, confining itself to opposing the further extension of slavery under the slogans Free Soil, Free Labor, Free States, Free Speech, and Free Men. But however low was the standard of the Free Soilers at Buffalo, they did lay the foundation of a grand superstructure. It was a powerful link in the chain of events by which the slave system has been abolished, the slave emancipated, and the country saved from dismemberment. In all this and more, it illustrates the experience of reform in all ages and conforms to the laws of human progress. Measures change, principles never.